Animals are our best friends. This is true because they are great company, they give us lots of positive emotions, and they are loyal to their owners. Some animals are unbelievably brave and risk their own lives to rescue people. Here's the top 5 animals who save people's lives. Number 1. When the World Trade Center collapsed on September 11, 2001, nearly 10,000 emergency rescue workers joined in the efforts to help. More than 300 of those heroes were dogs. We remember and honor the hero dogs of 9/11 along with the countless people who had their lives irrevocably changed by man's best friend. From search and rescue dogs to comfort dogs to bomb detection dogs, these canine stories of courage and healing are a long-lasting legacy that must never be forgotten. These hard-working dogs were scouring day and night in the hazardous location. Not only were they looking for survivors, but they were also comforting them, sharing their warmth and empathy in this horrific moment. The heroes will not be forgotten. Brittany the Golden Retriever. Brittany, pronounced Brittany, was 2 years old at the time of the attacks. She and Denise Corliss, her owner and handler, worked at Ground Zero for 10 days as their mission went from rescue to recovery. Corliss, a volunteer firefighter with the Cyfair Fire Department, began training Brittany for search and rescue work at just 8 weeks old. The duo soon became a FEMA-certified canine team that also worked in the rescue missions during Hurricanes Katrina, Rita, and Yvonne. Brittany retired from formal search work at 9 years old, but continued to work as a goodwill ambassador for her local fire department, and as a reading assistance dog at a local elementary school. Britannia remained the only living 9/11 search and rescue dog until June 6, 2016, when she was laid to rest just shy of 17 years old. As Brittany entered the animal hospital in Cypress, Texas, firefighters and search and rescue workers from the fire department lined the sidewalk and saluted. She was carried out later, her body draped in an American flag. Riley the Super Dog. Riley, a golden retriever that assisted in the 9/11 search and rescue efforts, was trained to find live people. Still, he did help recover several bodies of firefighters. But Riley worked desperately to find the living, that was his job. His search partner and human explained, Riley knew the people he continued to find were dead. He was never a formally trained cadaver dog. His job was to find the still living. I tried my best to tell Riley he was doing his job. He had no way to know that when firefighters and police officers came over to hug him, and for a split second you can see them crack a smile, that Riley was succeeding at doing an altogether different job. He provided comfort. Or maybe he did know. Apollo the German Shepherd. Apollo and his handler, Peter Davis, were called in to assist with rescue operations after the 9/11 terror attacks. They arrived at the World Trade Center site 15 minutes after the attack, making Apollo the first search and rescue dog to arrive after the collapse of the towers. At one point, Apollo was almost killed by flames and falling debris. However, he survived, having been drenched after falling into a pool of water just before this incident. Apollo started working again as soon as Davis brushed the debris off him. Number 2. Meet Khan, a Doberman pincher who became a hero when he saved 17-month-old Charlotte Svilsik from the deadly bite of a venomous king brown snake. Danger lurks in the family garden. It happened one warm day a few years ago in the land down under when a little girl named Charlotte was playing in the family garden under the watchful eye of her mother. Suddenly Khan's behavior changed and the dog began to snarl loudly. He attempted to nudge the toddler away from where she was standing, but she wouldn't move. Unbeknownst to anyone else and visible only to Khan was the world's third most venomous snake lying under the family home. Desperate, Khan picked her up by her diaper and gently tossed her a few feet behind him. The movement startled the king brown snake and it lunged forward, biting poor Khan on the paw. Khan reacted immediately to the deadly, venomous bite. After being bitten, Khan ran inside and immediately collapsed. Charlotte's mother rushed the brave animal to TTHE vet who administered an antivenom shot. Poor Khan spent a very painful night in the hospital, but he made a full recovery and ate a large breakfast the next day. A local snake expert informed the press that Khan may have escaped death because the snake was not able to inject a large amount of venom into his paw. Results would have been different and certainly lethal if the bite had pierced little Charlotte's skin. The child's mother witnessed the terrifying incident. Charlotte's mother, Catherine, informed the press, "If I had not seen it with my own eyes, I would never have believed it. Khan was really concentrating, he kept trying to nudge her but it wasn't working, so he grabbed her by the back of her nappy, and threw her over his shoulder more than a meter, about 3 feet. Charlotte looked pretty shocked and Khan screamed, as if he had been stabbed. I quickly realized that it was a snake and that Khan had been trying to get between her and the snake before he threw her. Brave Khan returned to his loving and ever grateful family who were incredibly moved by this dog's selflessness and heroism. Charlotte's mother told the press that Khan was starving, had been severely beaten and suffered from broken ribs when he had been brought into the shelter where her family found him. She said, "He was an abused dog. It was borderline on whether or not he should be put down because he was in such a bad way. The dog and the child are both fine and happy and the Doberman's name is Khan the Wonder Dog." Number 3. Robert Biggs, an experienced mountain hiker, was trekking in the California woods when he noticed a mother bear with her child. Robert stopped for a moment to watch them, but all of a sudden a mountain lion attacked him from behind. Thanks to his backpack, the wild animal couldn't reach the man's face. Still, he was no match for the mountain lion and at that point, only luck could save Mr. Biggs. Which unexpectedly came from the mother bear. She pounced on the lion and chased it away into the woods. The hiker came out with minor injuries and everlasting memories. Number 4. 4-year-old Ning Nong had become a trusted companion to 8-year-old Amber during her month-long winter holiday with her parents in Thailand in 2004. Every day she would hurry to the beach to ride on his back along the shore, and he would wrap his trunk protectively around her shoulders as she fed him bananas. After celebrating Christmas in paradise with Mum Samantha and Stepdad Eddie, she couldn't wait for a Boxing Day adventure on with the 4-year-old elephant on the beach in Kerangthal Resort. In the Sheraton Hotel just above the beach that morning the family had felt a small tremor, but thought nothing of it. Then, as Amber took her daily ride on Ning Nong, the tide suddenly receded. During one of the worst natural disasters, the tsunami in Thailand in 2004, Amber Owen was there on vacation. One morning she was riding Ning Nong the elephant. Everything seemed fine, but at some point, the elephant started moving back from the sea. The girl noticed a huge wave approaching. She was shocked and very scared while Ning Nong ran as far away as possible from the deadly sea. He took her to a safe place where she could climb down and reunite with her family. The elephant's bravery was so outstanding that it inspired Michael Morpurgo, a famous British writer, to write a play about what happened. Number 5. A British endurance swimmer was attempting to swim between New Zealand's two main islands when he realized he was not alone. Adam Walker, a British swimmer, was in the midst of his 8-hour marathon in the Pacific Ocean when he saw a huge white shark not far from him. His 6th swim was likely to be his last one, if it hadn't been for a group of dolphins who shielded the man and followed him for the next hour. Adam got lucky twice, his dream of swimming with dolphins came true, and his life was saved by these beautiful and kind creatures. As the shark got close, a pod of dolphins encircled him and seemed to shield him from the shark. They stayed with him for over an hour as he carried on his 26-kilometer swim, which eventually took him just over 8.5 hours to complete. Dolphins are known to be lifesavers for rescuing drowning or unconscious people and pushing them towards the shore. Thanks to their intuition, they can feel danger and are brave enough to come to the rescue. Mr. Walker is aiming to be the first British person to complete the Ocean 7 Challenge, which entails swimming 7 of the toughest open water swims in the world. He has now completed 6 of the 7 swims, including the English Channel, and has only the North Channel between Northern Ireland and Scotland to go. Inspired by an in-flight film on the way to Australia, Mr. Walker is swimming to raise money for whale and dolphin conservation. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe.